So what's happened to us? Not that we have lost, you know, our soul, but that we find ourselves behind in areas that we used to take pride in leading.
Well, let's begin with our government, because that's an important part in the puzzle of what makes democracy work. We have a great constitution, but campaigning has taken over governing. We live in an era of the permanent campaign, and so we elect people to office, and then they campaign for office again instead of moving the ball forward. So I think that's a big problem, and that's what propelled me to write the book with my wonderful co-author, Dennis Thompson, and we thought we had to give a diagnosis of the problem and some of the solutions to it. For American universities, which are still the greatest in the world, we really depend upon American democracy helping us move our country forward and to give opportunity.
You seem to say that the spirit of compromise is less present today than it has been.
It seems to be quite dramatically, and the causes of that are multiple. We have a 24/7 news cycle, which has very narrow horse race coverage, and the horses are on steroids, and the steroids are funded by the ubiquity of money in politics. Money is more prevalent and important in politics than ever before, and relationships among congressmen and relationships of politicians to one another across the aisle have really faded as a consequence. So, in fact, compromise is at a disadvantage when politicians are standing on principle and demonizing their opponents instead of making deals.
And people will argue the following, too, that they no longer do politicians even, they leave on Thursday and they come back on Tuesday. And so there is not much fraternization, if that's the word, between politicians when they are not fighting each other.
And that's a critical absence. I like to say that when it comes to compromise, familiarity breeds attempt.
Yes.
That is, if you don't know people, you don't even try.
And you certainly don't trust.
And you don't trust. And if you're campaigning all the time and raising money all the time, you're not spending the time that's needed with your colleagues. Colleagues who you can disagree with greatly, but when a push comes to shove, Ted Kennedy and Orrin Hatch made compromise after compromise that moved health care forward
Reagan
in this country.
And Tip O'Neill
The Tax Reform Act of 1986 was the greatest tax reform in arguably a century, and it was Ronald Reagan and Tip O'Neill and Dan Rostenkowski and Bob Pack.
Right.
Bill Bradley.
Join us online at charlierose.com.